So the Mulani journey begins back in 1956, a little over 61 years now. And back then, my grandfather had newly immigrated from Italy over to Vancouver.
My grandpa, he started it, 1956, the year my dad was born. And it was just like a tiny little shop. Like, I think my dad said he had like two guys working for him.
Coming as an immigrant from Italy with only $50 in his pocket, my grandfather, Demetrio, came here when he was very young and started as a shoe shiner and then kind of got into the trades of plumbing and that kind of thing.
The chief, as we called him, started the business basically with the drainage department. He would work for the railroad, and at nighttime he would come home and he would just put his pick and shovel into potato sacks and go off and do a drainage job. And that's how the business basically started.
Plumbing, you know, it's kind of one of those things that's invisible almost. It's behind the walls. You don't really see the infrastructure put in place for it, but the importance of it is so great. Plumbing systems, heating system, drainage systems, they're the framework of any proper functioning society.
Chief used to always be proud of his team and reminded them that they were just as important as doctors for the health of the nation.
It's really great to see a lot of the younger generation getting into trades. It's something that is very fulfilling when you're working with your hands and you're able to create something or finish something and have the end result and look at it and watch it work.
My grandpa, he never even had his license. So it was always my grandma driving him to and from work every day. And she'd always had her hand in something and helping the business out.
My mother, whose name was Linda, was the driver and chauffeur for my father because he never drove. I remember many times going to school at nighttime, my father would have to go give estimates for job. So my mom would drive him to the job sites and I'd be in the car just doing my homework.
And eventually, when the business grew to have one or two trucks, then she was the one going around collecting all the laborers and dropping them off at the job site. And then she would collect everyone and drop them back at the house.
I was here when the chief was here, and he was definitely a huge fixture here. Like, he would open the shop every morning. He was the one who closed up every night. He'd be at his desk, and yeah, a lot of people would come in to talk to him, and you'd ask him for a part, and he would go and find it. You know, he knew where everything was back there, and he kept all the little things, right?
My father was a very happy man, and he used to write poetry. A lot of times he would write customers a poem, and even sing them a song.
A lot of the chief's poem was about transformation and be a better version of yourself. He inspired a lot of people, and I think his legacy is felt to this day. He's played a huge role in influencing Vern to the man he is now.
I started working for my dad full-time in 1974, and at that time we had two trucks. And then fast forward to when I bought the company in 1986. We originally were at McKay & Kingsway, and right across the street from us was the old Royal Bank building, which was the head office at that time. And so we decided to move, so I had to find another location. I found this location here, just east of Royal Oak at 5526 Kingsway. Over the course of the next few years, between 1986 and 1988, I drew up plans and we built at this location where we are right now.
When the business was half moved here, obviously there was very little staff that was here, particularly at nighttime. So we had to sleep here on the cement floor with some make-do mattresses and pillows. And we would have like these little night picnic and just sort of like make the best of it. And the next morning, Vern would just go right back to work.
Oh, when Nicole and I first met, she used to help me with a lot of different things, like building shelving and fulfilling a lot of different roles to help me expedite and finish the building. And I grew the business from there. So over the next 5 years, I grew the business from two trucks to 10 trucks. And it was a lot of fun, but and a lot of hard work. But you know what? Hard work is something that I've never shied away from. At Milani, we really believe in giving back to our community. Myself, I've been on a number of nonprofit boards. I've been a director for the Burnaby Hospital Foundation for numerous terms, and also for the Better Business Bureau, just to name a few.
One of the charity that's very dear to Vern's heart is Children's Hospital and BC Cancer Society.
We do, you know, what we can to protect the environment. So our entire company fleet runs on non-greenhouse emitting gas. You know, we do energy audits and upgrades for buildings, making them more energy efficient. We use environmentally eco-friendly products wherever we can as well. So it's definitely something that's important at Milani.
We're doing more than anybody else that I can see in the industry. Going electronic too with the paperwork and stuff, I think is gonna make a big difference to the company, making us more efficient and stuff and help with growth even more, right? So yeah, I mean, we'll take over the market. Basically.
Since I started with the company, I've grown the company from 2 trucks to just under 100 trucks. And I do believe that there's still a lot more room for growth.
It's going to be exciting because, you know, with the changes, and with all the new equipment coming out and all the new technology and all the new parts and working with other people, working with businesses and working with buildings and everything's changing, but yeah, I think it's going to be good for the future. I think it's going to be really, really good.
It's an exciting time at Milani right now. There's a lot of expansion and growth. Systems that are being put in place to adapt with the changing marketplace, and there's a lot of opportunity out there for growing as a company and serving more and more people.
There's a lot more room for growth, and over the next 20 years, you know, God willing, staff willing, I plan to grow the company across Canada.
There's a lot of good stuff on the horizon, absolutely. And yeah, it's going to be exciting to see us in the next couple of years.